We know inequalities can be solved just like equations, but there's one exception. An inequality sign behaves differently when you multiply or divide both sides by a negative value. Let's look at that. I'm going to start by not doing division or multiplication. I'm going to do subtraction. First, I subtract 1 from both sides, and I get 1 is greater than 0. Then I can subtract 2 from both sides, and I get negative 1 is greater than negative 2. This causes a lot of trouble for students. Let's look at this. Here's negative 1, and here's negative 2. We know negative 1 is closer to 0. It's further to the right on the number line, so it must be bigger in value compared to negative 2. But we're not after comparing numbers here. We want to know about the inequality sign. I've rewritten negative 1 is greater than negative 2, and instead of doing the subtraction twice, what if we just would have multiplied? If we multiply both sides of our inequality by negative 1, we'll get negative 2 and negative 1. But I can't just carry my inequality straight down. We know negative 1 is greater than negative 2. So this sign has to reverse in direction. The same is true when dividing by a negative 1. We know when we divide by a negative 1, we change the signs of the numbers. So I'll still need to flip my inequality sign. These inequalities might look different, but they're actually equivalent statements. Here I have negative 1 is greater than negative 2, and here I have negative 2 is less than negative 1. If we flip this entire inequality, we can see that we wind up with the same thing. We get negative 2 is less than negative 1. The key thing to remember when solving inequality problems is to reverse the direction of the sign when you multiply or divide both sides by a negative.